You are welcome in Jesus' name. We are still on our teaching series, Edification, and we have another topic before us today, life in the spirit. And the essence of this edification is to build up believers to come to the fullness of the stature of Christ, and that's the essence. So we want to look how a Christian should live his life. That is how to live a Christian life. So that's what we want to look today. Before we proceed, I want us to pray. Father, we thank you. We appreciate you for another opportunity to learn at your feet. As we go into your word, pray that you take absolute control. Let the heart of every listener be receptive to your word. In the name of Jesus, anoint my lips afresh to speak as an oracle. Do that which only you can do. Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Life in the Spirit. I pick my text from the book of Galatians, chapter 5, verse 19 to 21. It says, when you follow the desires of your sinful nature, the results are very clear. Sexual immorality, impurity, lustful pleasures, idolatry, sorcery, hostility, quarreling, jealousy, outburst of anger, selfish ambition, dissension, division, then envy, drunkenness, wild parties, and other sins like this. Let me tell you again, as I have before, that anyone living that sort of life will not inherit the kingdom of God. That's Galatians chapter 5, verse 19 to 21, New Living Translation. Apostle Paul was writing to the Galatians that if you are gratifying your sinful nature, you are living, you are fulfilling, you are satisfying the desires of sinful nature, desires of the flesh, these are the things that you will have. These are the results. Your flesh will produce this result. Began to mention then, talks about immorality, sexual immorality, impurity, lustful pleasure, and many other things like that. So God wants us as a believer, after you have given your life to the Lord Jesus Christ, He wants you to live your life for Him. He wants you to live according to the dictates of the Word of God. When you gave your life to the Lord Jesus Christ, it was your spirit man that became a new creature. If anyone is in Christ, a new creature, all things are passed away, all things have become new. That's 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17. But it was your spirit man that becomes a new creature. But your mind, that is your soul and your body, they are still unregenerated. The way they had, they still remain the same. So you have a responsibility to walk on your mind, that is your soul, and to walk on your body. That's why in Romans chapter 12, verse 1, it says you should present your body as a living sacrifice. In verse 2 of it, he said you should renew your mind. You should not conform to the world. Renew your mind. So you have a responsibility to deal with your flesh and subdue it as a believer. So the responsibility is yours to deal with the flesh, because now that you have come to the Lord Jesus Christ, your flesh will still be demanding for those things you have been doing before you accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior. I read Colossians chapter 3, verse 5, Amplified Bible. So put to death and deprive of power the evil longings of your earthly body with its sensual, self-centered instinct, immorality, impurity, sinful passion, evil desire, and greed, which is a kind of idolatry because it replaces your devotion to God. He said that you should put to death and deprive the power of evil longing. That is, your power, your flesh has the power to longe for evil, desire for evil. This evil instinct is there. It's part of the sinful nature we inherited from Adam. So that nature is there in the flesh. But you have a responsibility now that you have given your life to the Lord Jesus Christ to deprive your flesh, that is to not to satisfy your flesh. When your flesh is desiring for this thing, you won't satisfy the desire of the flesh. So you need to subdue the flesh. So flesh will demand from you things contrary to the word of God. Flesh will be demanding from you things that are contrary to the word of God. Things that are not in line with the word of God. Sinful things. That is, flesh will still be demanding for those things you have been doing before you gave your life to the Lord Jesus Christ. Now, I read again, for the flesh lusts against the spirit, and the spirit against the flesh. The flesh and these are contrary to one another, so that you do not do things that you wish. That's Galatians 5, verse 17. That is, the flesh is lusting against the spirit. The spirit is lusting against the flesh. What you wish to do, what your spirit man wishes to do, your flesh will not want your spirit man to do it. That is, the real you, that is, the inner man, what the inward man wants to do to satisfy God, to please God, now the flesh will be resisting that, will not want him to do that. So if you follow desires of the flesh, your life will produce evil results. Your life will produce corruption. So flesh has to be dealt with in your life. Sinful desires have to be subdued. So you need to deal with your flesh. You deal with the sinful desires. So if you feed your flesh, you will reap corruption. There are a lot of believers, they claim to have given their life to the Lord Jesus Christ, but they are feeding their flesh instead of them to feed their spirit, to feed their spirit so that their spirit can grow. The inward man, for their inward man to grow, they don't feed their spirit. They feed their flesh and they reap corruption as a result of that. I read Galatians chapter 6, verse 8. For he who sows to his flesh will of the flesh reap corruption, but he who sows to the spirit will of the spirit reap everlasting life. So if you are sowing to your flesh, you will reap corruption, that destruction. And if you are sowing to your spirit, you will reap everlasting life. You become mature in the Lord. But if you are sowing to your flesh, then you live your life like unbelievers. And eventually, you may lose your salvation and you may end in hell fire. So, study the word of God and live by the principles of the word to subdue your flesh. If you want to subdue your flesh, you study the word of God, so that you can live by the principles of the word. Because you have a responsibility to walk on the flesh and the mind, that is your soul. And if you read the book of James chapter 1, verses 23 and 25, he said, a man who beholds himself in a mirror is like a person who beholds the word of liberty, that is the word of God, and works in that word, continue in that word. So he wants you not to just read the word or hear the word. He wants you to practice the word, to do the word. So pray more in the language of the spirit. In Jude verse 20, say, building up yourself on your most holy faith by praying in the Holy Spirit. So with the help of the Holy Spirit, you can live above sin. You can subdue your flesh. You can live above sin. I read the book of John chapter 14, verse 17. It said, the spirit of truth, that is the Holy Spirit, whom the world cannot receive, because it neither sees him nor knows him. But you know him, for he dwells with you and will be in you. The essence of the Holy Spirit in us, because he dwells in us at new birth, after you have given your life to the Lord Jesus Christ, Holy Spirit comes to reside on the inside of you. And the essence of him being on the inside of you is to help you to live a Christian life, to live a victorious Christian life. So the journey starts with the renewal of mind. So if you want to subdue the flesh, you start with your mind. That is, you work on your mind. Your mind is the seat of thoughts. Because whatever your flesh will carry out will start from your mind. You will have thought it in your mind. before your flesh will carry it out, will put that thought into action. So you need to work on your mind. What comes out of your mind defiles you. We see that in Matthew chapter 15, verse 18 to 20. Matthew 15, 18 to 20. Jesus was telling them that what goes into a man does not defile a man. It's what comes out of the man. That is, because out of your heart come evil thoughts, evil desires. So that's what defiles you. So if you don't work on your mind, then you will still be living according to the flesh. Your flesh will still be leading you. You will still be committing sin. But if you work on your mind, when you change your thoughts, your thinking, then the way you live will change. So your mind produces things programmed into it. So that's why you need to be careful on what you feed your mind with, what you program into your mind, because what your mind will produce is what you are programming to it. So you cannot live better than the state of your mind. If you want to live a good Christian life, then you need to work on your mind. You need to feed your mind with the Word of God, with things that can edify you, with things that can help your relationship with God. So if you feed your mind with things that cannot help you in your Christian journey, you will reap corruption. So if you are feeding your mind with dirty things on net, now on social media, on television, on radio, if you are feeding your mind with dirty things, then you will reap corruption. But if you are feeding your mind with the Word of life that can edify you, that can help you, promote you, increase your relationship with God, then you reap everlasting life. So the Word of God, to renew your mind, that is to change your thinking, you need consistent study of the Word of God. So if you want to change your thinking, if you want to renew your mind, it has to be done by the Word of God, no other way. Now, you cannot change your mind without paying attention to the Word of God. It is through the knowledge of the Word of God. Growth in godly character is through the knowledge of the Word of God. If you want to grow in your relationship with God, you want to form godly character in your life, you want to bear fruit, then it has to be by studying the Word of God, by reading it, by studying it, by meditating in it, and by applying it into your life. Now, the Word of God is the secret of greatness in the kingdom. God will relate with you based on the level of your knowledge about Him. Your level of your knowledge about God determines your relationship with Him. He will relate with you based on the level of your knowledge about Him. If your level the level of your knowledge about Him is shallow, then your relationship with Him will not be deep. It will be shallow as well. So how much you know Him determines how much you receive from Him. I read 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 14. But the natural man does not receive the things of the Spirit of God, for they are foolishness to him, nor can he know them, because they are spiritually discerned. The natural man there means a carnal man, a carnal person, somebody that cannot discern the things of the Spirit. So after you have given your life to the Lord Jesus Christ, then you're supposed to grow in the Spirit. But if you refuse to work on your mind, to work on your flesh, then you're natural people, like unbelievers. So when you are like that, then you cannot discern, you cannot understand the things of the Spirit. You cannot, your relationship with God cannot be deep. It will be shallow, because those who worship God, they worship Him in spirit and in truth. He wants us to worship Him in spirit and in truth. So God will not commit any serious thing into your hand if you are shallow in your knowledge of Him. If your relationship with Him is shallow, you are shallow in your knowledge of Him, you will not be able to commit any serious thing into your hand, because you are still a novice. You are still a baby Christian. You are a carnal Christian, body rule Christian. And God does not want you to remain at that level. He wants you to grow. There are many, they claim to have given their life to the Lord Jesus Christ for many years now, they still remain a baby Christian, and that's not the state God wants you to be. So many who claim to be Christian live in sin because they have a depraved mind, mind that is morally bad. They still live in sin like unbelievers. They fail to work on their minds, so they do not renew their mind. They don't renew their mind. So as you pay attention to the word of God, your thinking will begin to change. So you need to renew your mind for your mind to come up, to be able to embrace the things of God, whatever God wants to reveal to you. That's why at that place, he said, a natural man cannot understand the things of God, the things of the Spirit. For you to understand the things of God, and if you can't understand the things of the Spirit, the things of God, there is no way you can know the plan he has for your life. And since you can't know the plan, there is no way you can fulfill that plan. So what that person will do, there are a lot of Christians, they don't understand the plan of God for their life. And as a result of that, they cannot fulfill that plan. So for you to understand the plan, fulfill the plan, then your mind has to be renewed. Then you have a good relationship with them. Then you'll be able to understand the things of the Spirit. So Holy Spirit will begin to reveal to you things that God has in plan. Because if you allow your mind to be renewed, you renew your mind, your thinking will change, then you begin to see things in God's perspective, in God's point of view, then you'll be able to understand him when he speaks, when he talks to you, talks with you, then you'll be able to understand him. In the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 2, I read verses 9 and 10. He said, but as it is written, I has not seen, nor hear heard, nor have entered into the heart of man the things which God has prepared for those who love him. Then verse 10 of it, but God has revealed them to us through his Spirit. For the Spirit searches all things. Yes, the deep things of God. He said the things that God has in plan for us, I has not seen it, he has not heard it. That is, through your mental reasoning, through your senses, you can't understand what he has in plan for you. But when you allow the Holy Spirit, you allow the word of God to renew your mind, to change your mind, then you'll be able to understand the things of the Spirit. And then he said that God has revealed them to us through his Spirit. Then for the Spirit searches all things, yes, the deep things of God. You'll be able to understand the deep things of God, the plan he has for your life. Now, the sermon, when you pay attention to reading, studying and meditation in the word of God, added with prayer in the Holy Spirit, you have a sound mind, and then you'll be able to discern things in the Spirit. So you always know step to take, what to do about the issues of life. I see a lot of Christians, they are stranded, they are confused, they are disturbed. Why? Because they don't know what to do now, because they cannot understand the plan of God for their lives. So for who has known the mind and the purposes of the Lord? I read 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 16, Amplified Bible. For who has known the mind and the purposes of the Lord so as to instruct him? But we have the mind of Christ. To be guided by his thoughts and purposes. He said, we have the mind of Christ so that we can be guided by his thoughts and his purposes. It is after you have renewed your mind, your thinking can change, you can be guided, you can be directed by him, by his Spirit, according to his thoughts and his purposes. So if your mind is dirty, if your mind is polluted, not renewed, you make wrong decisions and poor choices in life. You see a lot of people, they make wrong decisions, poor choices in life. Why? Because they have a dirty mind. They can't reason like God. They can't think like God. They can't understand what God has in plan for them. They can't see what God has in plan, as proposed for their life. So you make decisions that are not right and choices that are not in line with God's plan for your life. If your mind is darkened, if it's dirty, if you fail to renew it, you make wrong decisions. You make choices that are not in line with the plan of God for your life. So your mind is important. Thus, you have to guard it. In the book of Proverbs chapter 4, verse 23, it says, keep your heart with all diligence, for out of it spring the issues of life. That's why you need to guard your mind. You keep your mind. You protect your mind with all diligence, because out of your mind comes out issues of life. He now says, so New Living Translation put it this way. He said, guard your heart above all else, for it determines the course of your life. Your mind determines the course of your life. That's a guard your heart above all else, above every other thing. That's why you don't just watch anything on TV, just don't watch any program on TV, anything that can contaminate your mind on net, on social media. You don't watch it. You don't listen to such a thing, because he said, guard your heart above all else, above every other thing. Some, they know how to guard their properties, they guard what they have, but they don't guard their mind. They expose their mind to just anything. So he said, guard your heart above all else, for it determines the kind of your life. It determines the course of your life. So if you want to have a fruitful life, you want to live a result-oriented life, then you guard your heart. Now, let God transform you by renewing of your mind. So you need to cooperate with the Holy Spirit, with the Word of God, so that your mind can be renewed. I read Romans chapter 12, verse 2, New Living Translation. It said, don't copy the behavior and custom of this world, but let God transform you into a new person. By changing the way you think, then you will learn to know God's will for you, which is good and pleasing and perfect. If you look at that place, then you should let God transform you into a new person by changing the way you think. That you can't become a new person without your thought being changed. If your thought is not changed, you are still like an unbeliever. You are still like the old person that you used to be. So if you allow God to transform you by changing the way you think, by renewing your mind, he said, then you will learn to know God's will. Through that, you learn to know God's plan for you, and which is good and pleasing and perfect. So living right as a Christian starts with change in the way you think. So if the way you think changes, then you begin to live right. You begin to live your life according to God's plan for your life. So you will learn to know God's will for you, which is good, pleasing, and perfect, if you allow your mind to be changed, if you allow your thoughts to be changed. Note, hearing the word, reading it, and studying it, plus meditation, transform your mind. If you are listening to the word, you are studying it, you are meditating on it, then this will transform your mind, will change your life completely. So you quieten your mind also by praying in the language of the Holy Spirit. So as you pay attention to what we have shared here, I see your life transform. I see you moving from new one level of glory to another, in the mighty name of Jesus. In this new year, 2021, you will move from glory to glory. You will not have a better last year, in the mighty name of Jesus. You'll be able to discover what God has in plan for you in this new year, and you'll be able to fulfill it, in the mighty name of Jesus. Peace, in Jesus' name.